The University of Colorado Health Hospital on the Anschutz Medical Campus is a nationally ranked hospital and part of the largest academic health center in the Rocky Mountain region. Inside UCHealth Hospital, you'd expect to see doctors, nurses, and technicians, but what may surprise you is the number of pharmacists who work in critical areas throughout the hospital. Most of us are familiar with pharmacists who perform a significant amount of dispensing functions, like working at drugstores and filling prescriptions. However, some pharmacists, commonly known as clinical pharmacists, never or rarely touch drugs and work in healthcare settings using solely their medication expertise. Unlike pharmacists who have significant dispensing roles, a clinical pharmacist may never actually count pills or bottle medications. Bottom line, all pharmacists are constantly using their medication knowledge to make sure drugs are used safely and appropriately. We'll be seeing pharmacists in both dispensing and clinical pharmacy roles on this tour. Many hospitals operate an outpatient pharmacy, like this one, an on-site dispensary, much like a community pharmacy, where patients can get their prescriptions filled before leaving the hospital. You've probably seen these before. What you might not have seen are the inpatient pharmacies that are usually located at the various hospital floors. Like the name implies, inpatient pharmacies serve the needs of patients who are in the hospital. These pharmacies are embedded throughout the hospital and are staffed by pharmacists who see patients and serve as a medication resource for other healthcare professionals like doctors, nurses, or dietitians. On this tour, our primary focus will be the inpatient pharmacy practice. Our first stop on the tour is the Oncology Satellite Pharmacy. This site specializes in treating the unique needs of cancer patients. Pharmacists in this satellite have dispensing responsibilities by handling drug products and making IV medications. They also have clinical roles. They enter and review all the drug orders, participate in rounds, make recommendations, and speak with patients about their chemotherapy regimens and discharge medications. One of the most picturesque stops on the tour is the glass bridge that will take us to our next stop. From this vantage point, you get a sense of why the 277-acre Anschutz Medical Campus is considered a world-class education and healthcare destination. The University of Colorado Hospital was named one of the best academic hospitals in the country, and along with the nationally ranked Children's Hospital, treats more than 2 million adult and pediatric patients every year. The campus as a whole is home to 6 schools and colleges, 60-plus health science centers and institutes, and more than 600 ongoing clinical trials at any one time. Our next stop is the Medical Intensive Care Unit, or MICU, pharmacist station. Some of the sickest patients in the hospital are located here. Note that this pharmacy area is much different than the oncology satellite pharmacy. It's open, without walls, and contains no drug products. This illustrates that the pharmacists working in the MICU are performing solely clinical functions. These pharmacists participate in patient care rounds with teams of healthcare professionals, monitor the patient's responses to drugs, and make dosing recommendations. This large space is the main inpatient pharmacy for the hospital. At night, when there are only 2 pharmacists on duty in the hospital, all pharmacy services operate from here. Pyxis machines exist throughout the hospital and are managed by pharmacy personnel. They exist to provide a secure cabinet in which drugs are stored in each area of the hospital. Primarily nurses access the Pyxis machines using their fingerprint and a PIN code, but pharmacists are needed to manage the technology and safety of the entire Pyxis system throughout the institution. Pharmacists also manage the protocols that dictate which drugs will be stored in which machines and how the machines will be stocked. These are examples of important technology functions that pharmacists can perform as part of their dispensing responsibilities. This location also features a compounding area for custom oral drugs, as well as a clean room where sterile IV products are made within special aseptic hoods. In the medication area, barcodes are used on every medication to ensure patient safety. And because this is an academic institution, at any given time there are up to 100 investigational new drug trials taking place, which means pharmacists are in charge of managing these highly controlled drugs and protocols to help in the determination of which drugs will ultimately be approved for public use. The hospital's emergency department is another key area where pharmacists play a critical role. The pharmacists here also serve primarily in a clinical capacity. Inside a trauma room, you'll find a Pyxis unit and the pharmacist station. If there were a real emergency going on, you'd see the pharmacist actively making recommendations for which drugs should be used and preparing IV drugs at the bedside. Whether in the emergency department or elsewhere in the hospital, a pharmacist responds to all stroke alerts. That's because the life-saving intravenous drug that can break up a clot in the brain costs up to $20,000 per dose. It's the pharmacist's job to quickly and accurately determine how much drug the patient should receive. The quicker this drug is administered, the better the outcome for the patient. It's easy to see why well-trained pharmacists play a vital role throughout the patient care experience in a hospital setting. Interested in exploring the field of pharmacy for yourself? Go to ucdenver.edu/pharmacy/explore and learn more about the dynamic ways that pharmacists are engaging on the front lines of healthcare.